Hi there, Devin here from American Aquarium. I want to thank you for taking a look at our lighting information. Today we'll be going over the ratings of Kelvin, nanometer range or spectrum, lux, PAR, measuring PAR, quality of light, photoinhibition, lumens, watts, and CRI. First off is Kelvin. This used to be the standard rating for aquarium lightings and is a rating that is to the eye, as in a specific Kelvin is a color that we see. This may not necessarily mean this is what a coral or a plant will use and see, but what our eye, which is more sensitive to specific colors. This is generally and now an outdated rule in the aquarium hobby, but still can be used with other measurements to understand what you are using over your aquarium. The Kelvin rating is on a scale of 0 Kelvin to 50,000 and higher Kelvin, with 50,000 being more of a cooler color to a range that we can't even see, and with the lesser Kelvin being warmer, more yellow. So on a warmer yellow scale to a blue or purple to we can't see scale. Generally speaking, we can say a certain Kelvin rating will achieve a certain growth from aquarium fixture, but not all aquarium fixtures are created equal, as in they could have the same Kelvin rating and be different in appearance and different in the actual light energy that's being received to our aquarium. Generally speaking, the planted aquarium will need about a 5,500 to 65K Kelvin to grow plants. This is trying to mimic the daylight sun. But again, this does not mean that every 6,500K and 5,500K is created equally, and there could be variations that are either better or not as good for growth. But generally, they will work. For saltwater aquarium, higher Kelvin is needed, as in 10,000K to 20,000K, as these, while they're cooler, also have a more penetrating effect, which is needed for corals' exoskeleton and actually receiving the light to their zooanthology to make it grow. Also consider each lamp that is being used or each emitter from the fixture, and knowing the Kelvin of each will give you a good idea of the overall rating. For much more information about Kelvin, please see the description below. Newer technology, specifically LEDs, use the nanometer spectrum range. This is another measurement of the eye, as in what color is being seen from the light emitting source, but is more tied to the vibration energy being emitted from the light source. Higher frequencies will have a more intense vibration. These vibrations technically are making color. These energies are making color that are visible to the eye. This nanometer range spectrum goes on a scale of 0 as well up to past 700 and above nanometers, but there's a certain range of nanometers that can be seen by the eye. Typically, it's between the 400 nanometer range and the 800 nanometer range that is visible to the eye. But it is known that outside this range, there's very important peaks that trigger very key aspects of growth for coral and plants. There are also very well-known nanometer ranges that provide certain colorations for plants and corals. Certain high-intense frequencies will also change the colors of plants because it's almost like blocking, so they're not getting sunburnt. The lux rating is the intensity of light hitting a surface over a given area. This could also be considered brightness to the eye. This is not a typical measurement used. It was an older technology specification that was used that gave you a general idea of how bright, meaning that it would can be considered to have more growing power, but it's still a good rating to know with all the other newer and more important specifications. 3000 lux would be on the bottom scale of brightness to be able to give something growth. Upwards to 100,000 lux, which would be needed to growing more specific high demanding plants and corals. Again, this is a very generic specification that does not give you specifics on what type of energy is being given to the plant and coral, but more an overall of how much is being given. There's more on lux in the article in the description below. PAR is now the standard of trying to understand how much specific energy is being received to the aquarium. This is the photosynthetically active radiation, or the energy, the active energy being provided to the aquarium. This is usually used as the starting point for most technology in the hobby and industry today. This is the given amount of spectrum nanometers total a plant or coral are receiving at that given moment. And again, there are known nanometers, PAR, that trigger certain responses in plants and coral needed for growth. They are generic, meaning that certain select samples were used and we have a baseline, but not every species of plant and coral have been tested. But generally speaking, we know what PAR, amounts of PAR nanometers is needed and which nanometers spectrum is needed for that certain response. When PAR was starting to be used, it was thought that we had to have a higher amount of PAR to make growth happen for plants and corals. As time went on and people's experiences with testing happened, we found out that we could have a far less PAR than speculated to make hard plants grow, or deeper plants grow, or harder to grow corals to grow. And now it's being found that if we know the certain nanometers to actually make a plant or coral grow, we can have a specific output of that nanometers, and then we can have far less PAR, or the total amount of energy being used, because now we're using more specific. And when I say this, I'm talking about growth. We are getting away with far less to make things grow, and that's the benefit of newer technologies like LEDs, because we were able to target specific nanometers, then have far less PAR to make those things grow. And this is what's being now promoted currently in 2017 and 18 in the hobby, is that far less can be used with target lighting than what was thought previously. Far less PAR is growing the hardest corals in the world. For just some general reference, for the planted tank, we have found that low PAR numbers of say 30, which is considered low, moderate would be maybe right under 100, and above 100 would be high PAR. We are finding that low PAR numbers can grow some of the most hardest plants. For corals, generally, we want a little more, but also specific to growth, and we can grow some of the most simplest soft corals with also 30 or less, a little less PAR, going up higher with harder Acropora. We can grow these now if we have specific target lighting and say 150 range PAR, where before it was thought that you had to have 400 PAR. And maybe we did have to have 400 PAR, but that was when we were not providing specific nanometers. We were using more of a shotgun approach where we were just providing all of the energy instead of specific energy. But now that we have new science, new technology, we're able to know specific specifics of what make things grow, and we can get away with far less. And these are actually providing better growth rates than more and the shotgun approach. More PAR may be needed if you are wanting to color a certain plant or coral. More in the corals range, you would want an overall PAR instead of a specific PAR because you'll lose coloration. So you want to consider the whole light source, and if you actually, although certain light emitting sources, you're at least getting the growth power, and then if you're also getting coloration. Both are equally important in today's standards. Most people don't want a real high growth tank, but like brown corals. They want growth and coloration. So learn about both, and you can have great growth and great coloration. What you don't want to have happen is great coloration, but not have the PAR in the right range to make growth happen. Because then you will not have a thriving tank. You'll have a very stagnant growth tank, even death to some corals and or plants. There are ways to measure PAR, the total amount PAR in a given position in the aquarium. These meters are a little more expensive. You can use just good logic of about how much you think you'd be getting, so they're not necessary. But if your aquarium is an investment, a PAR meter may be important to have. Equally as important, and even arguably more important, is the PUR measurement, which goes hand in hand to PAR. I've already said it, but I'm going to reframe it using the term PUR, which is photosynthetic useful radiation. These are numbers that are now provided by manufacturers to tell you how much radiation is given for those specific spectrums of known growth and coloration. So PUR is useful when trying to figure out how much growth power something has. So we take the nanometer range of the known growth aspects of photosynthesis, and the PUR measurement will tell you how much energy is in that specific useful range known by today's science. There are new meters to measure PUR. They're very expensive on the hobby market, typically not needed for the hobby, more for industry standards, typically not even in the aquarium hobby, in the higher end scales, say of reef keeping, and more importantly, agriculture, knowing the total amount of specific wavelengths to make foods grow. That's very important and becomes very valuable information. This is now a good time to bring in photoinhibition, which is basically the idea that you can provide too much light for given plants or corals to grow. And the fact is, too much of any given or too intense of an amount of light given can actually stunt the growth of the plant or coral. So watch for not having too much. In the reefing community, this is well known that you'd want to start corals at less light and work their way up to more intense amounts of light. And with plants, you can also see that the plant will be stunted of growth, possibly die back and have to readjust to the new growth, and then also some plants may turn a different color trying to protect themselves from the high intensity light. One last measurement that's important to know, it's not typically a standard anymore, is the lumen rating. This is another rating to the eye of how much of a given light, as in the higher the lumen, the brighter to the eye, less of the lumen, not as bright. Lumens can be important if you want to figure out the effectiveness of your light, as in the amount of light given per watt. And this is where we get into input energy and output energy. Consider the amount of watts, which is the amount of energy to drive the lighting source, and the output of how much PAR or lumens. And a calculation can be figured out about how effective your light source is. There are fixtures that will take far more input watts and get far less output effectancy, and there's fixtures that will have very high effectancy, as in takes very low watts and gives out very high growth power for plants and corals. This is kind of where the industry standard is going now, where there will, where the goal is to have far less input energy and get far more growth. And this helps industries be able to save and get more. So it's very important at the industry level. And it's good to understand at the hobby level, even long term, there are fixtures that will be more efficient, that may be slightly more expensive, but in the long run will be the cheaper option. And there are fixtures that will be not as efficient, will get the job done, and become the far more expensive fixture in the long run. The last specification that I'd want to go over is CRI, which is being used as an industry standard now, but can be misleading. If you'd like to know more about CRI and see actually some picture examples, please take a look at the link in the description below. Thank you everyone for listening to this talk on our lighting information. I hope it was helpful for you. We appreciate you at American Aquarium. Know that we're trying to be an information provider first and help educate the hobby and industry with lots of years of experience, lots of applications to test from, research, and helping going in and helping the hobby and industry. So we thank you for your support, and take a look at the other lessons that we have in our YouTube channel and the other articles that we have on American Aquarium. Thank you very much. Bye.